Please rise. Grace, mercy, and peace be to you from God our Father, and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. The text for this morning's sermon is the lesson from the Holy Gospel. And my dear friends, just as Jesus had a question for his disciples, Jesus has a question for you. You may be seated. Dear fellow redeemed in Christ Jesus, what do you find offensive? There are a number of things that I find offensive. Some of them may have to do with the world of sports, others with politics, but most of all, what offends me the most is those who say that they are Christians, that they are followers of Christ Jesus, yet they refuse to follow Him. They pay lip service to Christ. They are like some of His followers in our text this morning. They want something from Jesus. In their case, they wanted a full stomach of bread. Nowadays, people want Jesus. They want Him to make them feel comfortable, or they want to be powerful, or they use Jesus to proclaim their own gospel. Jesus knew that His words offended those who truly did not know Him, who truly did not believe that He was the Messiah, that He was about to sacrifice Himself. All this flesh and blood talk offended them. And all this flesh and blood talk that you've been hearing about over the past 2 weeks, I pray that it doesn't offend you. You see, the Jews just couldn't understand. They couldn't grasp the idea that Jesus was the Messiah and that He came to sacrifice Himself, the ultimate sacrifice, for sin, for all sin, for your sin, for my sin, even for their sin. The word that is used in the Old Testament is that they were scandalized. And I pray that none of you are scandalized as you are encouraged, as Jesus says, to eat His flesh and to drink His blood. In other words, Jesus, His sole desire is for you to believe that He died for you here at the cross and that He rose for you. And today, most of you will come forward to eat His flesh and drink His blood, in with and under bread and wine. More on that in a moment. Whenever the Jews would raise these objections, Jesus would turn the tables on them. He says to them, "What if you see the Son of Man ascend to where He was before?" He says that the Spirit gives life. The flesh counts for nothing. The words I have spoken to you are Spirit, and they are life. Yet some of you do not believe. My friends, I know that you know people like this. I know a lot of people like this. They like to brag. They like to tell you that they can do anything and everything better than you or anyone else. Essentially, they are blowhards. They are braggarts who will fold when the tough times come. During my time in the service, I saw this over and over again. We always knew the soldier or soldiers that when it was time to go into combat, they wouldn't be going forward. They would be going backwards, back to the back line. They usually had an excuse. My foot hurts. I have a hangnail. My tooth hurts. It's usually something medical. Oh, they talk the talk, but they never ever walk the walk. So Jesus says to those who are grumbling and ready to leave, He says that you are grumbling against a teaching that is the truth. Not only is it the truth, but I can prove that it's the truth. It's the truth because I am the Son of God and the Son of Man. And I came from heaven. I came to heaven for a sole purpose. And that purpose was sacrifice. Not only will I be able to prove, but I will show you that my teaching is the truth. And he proved it at the cross, and he proved it at the tomb, which, by the way, is still empty. My friends, Jesus is telling each and every one of you, don't you realize that I'm not talking about you literally eating my flesh and drinking my blood? The fleshly, the physical side of life counts for nothing. It isn't real life. Now I diverge a little bit. And I talk to all the young people in the congregation. I know that in school you hear different things and different theories and different ideas about life. My friends, what you hear in school, what you hear from your friends isn't life. When you come to church and when you come to Sunday school, you are hearing about life. When you hear the Word of God, you're hearing the words of life. Why is this? Because only the Holy Spirit gives us life. He gave life last week to Bryn. Next week he will give new life to Ty. He gave new life to each and every one of you at that font or wherever you may have been baptized. You see, life is the work of God. He does this through the Word, the same Word that Jesus spoke and speaks today. As a matter of fact, the words that Jesus speaks, they are Spirit-filled words. They are holy words. So every time you read your Bible, you are reading a Spirit-filled book. It just isn't black ink on white paper. They are words of life. And what do they grant to you? My friends, they grant to you something that is far more valuable than your PlayStation, far more valuable than your television, far more valuable than your friends. They give to you freely eternal life. But Jesus says, yet there are some of you who do not believe. As it was then, so it is today. Even though the words of Jesus Christ are words of life, still people resist, they refuse to believe that they are words of life. And what makes this even more horrible, what makes this more horrendous, is that there are Christians who say they believe, but their actions don't reflect it. And that's offensive. Some people turn away. They play lip service to Jesus. They're here on Easter. They're here on Christmas, and we never see him again. That's paying lip service to Jesus. He wants you in the Word each and every day of your life because the flesh counts for nothing. The words are life. But we see from our text this morning that some people, they are so hard-hearted, they are so entrapped by Satan that they immediately reject the words of life. And as Jesus says, they have no life in them. He also says later in the book of John, this is why I told you that no one can come to me unless the Father has enabled him. To his disciples who believed, and to each and every one of you who believe, he explains what is happening. Jesus points out a truth that we heard 2 weeks ago, no one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. Now, my friends, especially to our young people here in the congregation, you need to listen to this. I don't care what anyone tells you. You cannot save yourself. You cannot make a decision for Jesus. It just doesn't work that way. You cannot believe on your own that Jesus is your Savior. You cannot come to Him by your own force or will. Your own reason or strength just doesn't work. Why? Because by nature, you and I just don't want to follow Jesus. We would rather be doing our own thing. We'd rather be doing our own living, our own thinking, where no one, especially our parents, are telling us how to think, what to do, and when to do it. But you know, adults are just as bad, maybe worse. You've heard the old saying, I know, the blind leading the blind. A spiritually blind person cannot go anywhere. They grope in the darkness and they try to convince themselves that they are the enlightened ones. A spiritual enemy of God doesn't want to follow Jesus. And it's only when the Lord turns the light on that the Holy Spirit convicts them of their sin, of their spiritual blindness, which then He leads them to repent, to confess their sin, and in their confession, the Lord then reverses that hostility that they had against Him, and He forgives them of their sin. Then, and only then, can a person follow Jesus. You see, it's nothing that we do. It's everything that He has done and continues to do. There were some who were blind that day. There were many, actually, who were blind that day as they walked away from Jesus. They walked away from the light of the world. They returned to their miserable lives, and they no longer followed Jesus. All who walk away and no longer follow Jesus will again, oh yes, again, they will see the light of the world, but He will judge them. And in His judgment, He will rightly condemn them because they refused to follow the light. They refused to believe that Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. So Jesus turns to the 12. So Jesus looks you square in the eye today and He says, you do not want to leave too, do you? You do not want to leave too, do you? Don't you want to follow the crowd? Our high school students, our middle school students, don't you want to do what your friends do? Be free and happy. Be rebellious. Don't pay attention to your parents. Get involved in all kinds of evil. That's the cool thing to do. You do not want to leave too, do you? My friends, He is calling to the 12, and He's calling to each and every one of you to speak the truth, to confess your belief. So Peter does just that. Peter confesses with one of the greatest confessions ever recorded by any man. We believe and know that You are the Christ, that You are the Holy One of God. Prior to that, Peter has his own question. To whom shall we go? There is no one else, Lord, who has given us life. There is no one else who has raised the dead. There is no one else who could die for our sins. There is no one else who could rise on the third day and give to us eternal life. If there is one, can you name him? You can't. Neither can I. There is only one. We believe and know that You are the Holy One of God. So my friends, how does this apply to you? This is how it applies to you. As you come to this altar this morning, I pray that you will believe that what you're receiving is the gift of forgiveness, the strengthening of your faith into life and salvation, in His body and blood. And as you are standing at this altar before you receive, if you want to say it out loud, it won't bother me. But I pray that you'll say it in your heart and in your mind. Lord Jesus, I believe that You are the Holy One of God. Jesus, I believe that You are the Holy One of God. And in Your confession, He forgives you of all your sins. The One who is worthy, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, is now here. He is now here to serve you, the ultimate sacrifice, the sacrifice that He gave for you. And He gives it to you in, with, and under bread and wine for the forgiveness of your sins, for the strengthening of your faith once again, for they are words of life and they are words of salvation. This free gift of His body and blood given freely to you because of His love for each and every one of you. Yes, Jesus, I believe and know that You are the Holy One of God. Amen. Please rise. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding, guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus, now and forever. Amen.